Thanks, Acorn TV, for sponsoring this video. Hi, my name is Mariana. I make videos on productivity, organization, task and time management, and other fun stuff. And today, I'll be helping you pick the perfect full-featured college organization app according to your personality and your needs. The idea here is to really simplify your workflow and get an app that is as all-in-one as it gets. Although these five apps today have different levels of in-depth features and simplicity, they're all powerful enough to help you get completely organized for the semester. You can choose to use only one of them at a time, or to pair them with a different app, or even a paper planner as well. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started with app number one. ClickUp is one of the best surprises I had last year. ClickUp has a free forever version, meaning you can basically use all of its features for free, no strings attached. Its core purpose is being an all-in-one app, so it's more geared towards task management, but they have a bunch of functions that incorporate knowledge-based systems as well. Okay, so with ClickUp, you can create to-do lists with a structure of tasks and subtasks, you can manage individual or team projects, assigning tasks to different people, prioritizing them, and then managing your workflow via timeline. You can also create documents and wikis, and actually build a whole knowledge base inside the software, with the same typical slash commands that you can find in Notion. You can also create spreadsheets to view your tasks, as well as embedding Google Sheets documents directly to edit and collaborate without leaving the app. You're also able to manage your email directly within the app, creating and automating tasks and subtasks from emails, and adding them to your task management system. ClickUp also provides calendar features with timelines, schedules, and Gantt charts that sync in time with Google, Outlook, and Apple calendars. And of course, you can also set up reminders as well. There are other features like time tracking, resource management, and comments and chats, which I'll not talk about today as they're more tailored towards business than academia. You will enjoy ClickUp if you need to balance task management and knowledge-based features, if you prefer using one organization app instead of multiple ones, if you don't mind a steeper learning curve, if you prefer complex programs and apps and already know a few things about time and task management, if you don't care about personalizing and creating an aesthetic for your organization system, if you want an organization system that you can use for other areas in your life besides college organization, and finally, if you really need a free app to get organized. Shovel is a study planner and is a combination of calendar and to-do list. The whole concept is using time boxing or calendar blocking to organize your schedule, assign your classes to specific time blocks, and then figure out when you should be doing your homework, projects, and study sessions. It features a really simple drag-and-drop system to allot tasks to your calendar and create a seamless study plan. Shovel has one feature that I'm yet to find in any other app, and it's called the cushion. The cushion graph basically tells you, according to what you've scheduled on your to-do list, whether you can get everything done on time or if you need to start cutting back on some of those tasks. In that way, Shovel incorporates a learning experience as well, and it allows you to learn how to manage your time better as time goes on, which is perfect for someone who is new in time management. It also tracks the time you spend studying for each course, which also lets you see if you're balancing your effort in different areas or if you need to rework your schedule. So you will enjoy Shovel if you need an app solely to manage college life, if managing your calendar and creating to-do lists are absolute essentials for you, if you're feeling a bit lost about organization and need to master a few essentials before moving on to more complex apps, if you want to skip building a knowledge base right now or don't mind using a different app for that, if you prefer simpler productivity tools and an easy app to use, if you don't care about personalizing and creating an aesthetic for your organization system, and if you do not mind paying for an organization app. Okay, so of course this one was coming, right? Notion is a free all-in-one tool that's fully customizable. It can be a knowledge base or a task management app, depending on your needs. Notion is organized around the concept of pages and blocks. So basically, you can give a topic to a page, as well as different categories, and then insert different blocks inside the page. These blocks can be text, tables, images, headings, embedded documents, calendars, timelines, you name it. You can move things around via drag and drop system, hierarchize pages like you would organize folders in your computer, share notes seamlessly with classmates, create lists, organize PDF documents, plan for your exams, and so on. It's incredibly powerful, and at the same time, it's simple enough for anyone to pick it up and start learning more about its functions, because you can actually import templates made from other users into your own workspace. You will enjoy Notion if you need an app that incorporates task management as well as knowledge database building functions, if you like the ability to share notes easily with other people, if you prefer an all-in-one app instead of relying on a bunch of different ones, if you want an organization system that you can use for other areas in your life besides college organization, if you want the ability to keep it simple at times, but also go in depth when needed, if you enjoy personalizing your workspace and creating an aesthetic for your system, and if you need a free organization app. Obsidian is a free app tailored to create a knowledge base on intricate and complex subjects. You can create your notes and organize them to provide a better learning experience. It works around the concept of jumping from idea to idea in a non-linear way, giving you the ability to archive information neatly while also creating the necessary backlinks between different subjects and topics, reinforcing your knowledge on the subject and showing you how some ideas are interconnected. This is translated into something they call the graph view, which is an overview mind map of your Obsidian entries. You can explore this graph, observe how topics relate to one another, and then add new topics or move them around. However, Obsidian is not very user-friendly. The user interface can be a bit confusing, and you'll have to spend some time navigating it to understand how everything works, which can be exciting for some people, but a bit daunting to other people. Also, Obsidian supports Markdown formatting in plain text, and it does have task management features, but for that you'll have to rely on plugins. There are a lot of them though, but incorporating them into your workspace isn't as seamless as already having those features built in the software itself. All in all, Obsidian is heavily focused on writing content and organizing set content. It's a student's ideal sandbox for heavy revision sessions, brainstorming, organizing research and projects, and deal with very complex subjects. Personally, I think Obsidian can be a great option if you want to explore its world of plugins, importing some task management features into your own workspace, or if you pair it with another simple app like Shovel, or either a to-do list app or a calendar app as well. So you'll enjoy Obsidian if you're looking for an app with the sole purpose of creating a knowledge base, if you don't mind using a different app to manage tasks or your calendar, if you feel like you already have a grasp on time management skills and task management and prefer to dedicate your attention to heavy studying, if you don't mind a steep learning curve and spending some time navigating your workspace, if you don't mind the process of browsing and adding plugins to unlock more features, and if you need a free organization app. Okay, so Rome Research is almost equivalent to Obsidian. It's a very comparable app, but it's not free. Rome Research has a better UI, it displays text really well, and just like Obsidian, it also supports Markdown in plain text. Backlinks in Rome Research work better than in Obsidian, so first of all, each note includes linked and unlinked mentions at the bottom, making it so much easier to navigate. And secondly, backlinks work really well in individual blocks as well, so in this sense, Rome Research is more similar to Notion than Obsidian. So while Obsidian considers that a note is the smallest entry in the database, in both Rome Research and Notion, the smallest entry is a block, and you can have several blocks in one note. This means that Rome Research works better to link micro-information, and you aren't as tied to the topic of each particular page or note like you would be in Obsidian. Rome Research also has a graph view, but it has something that completely detracts from the experience, as it lacks filters or any ability to clear up the graph while you're navigating it. The more entries you have, the more unreadable the graph will become, which can be pretty disappointing after spending so much time writing your notes. So you will enjoy Rome Research for the same reasons you would enjoy Obsidian. Both are very similar, so if you're still undecided between the two of them, I'll link down below a full comparison article written by The Sweet Setup, which has a thorough breakdown of every single feature and component in both apps. And before I leave you, don't forget to schedule Acorn TV's new weekly release in your calendar. You're probably tired of watching virtually every single show available on most platforms by now, after more than a year of full or partial lockdown. So Acorn TV has a lot of shows you probably never watched, like Whitstable Pearl, a classic detective series perfect to watch if you like to cozy up with a good mystery novel, and which is streaming right now. What I love the most about Acorn TV is their period drama catalog. There's so much to choose from The Miniaturist to All Creatures Great and Small or The Plague. Everything on Acorn TV is commercial-free, so no weird surprises there, and it costs way less than more streaming platforms, at $5.99 per month. It also works with all platforms and devices, so there's always something new to discover every time you feel like watching something new. If you want to try it out and see for yourself on what you're missing out, don't forget to use the link down below to get a 30-day free trial, or click the link right on the screen because they're going to release a bunch of stuff really soon, so it's time to add all these new shows to your calendar. I hope you've enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you next week. Bye, guys!